Okay, so today we're going to try something a little different for this series. Instead of discussing a movie theory or analyzation, instead we'll be discussing and analyzing a plot hole I found in one of my favorite childhood shows, Rugrats, a 90s Nickelodeon show about a bunch of babies going on adventures and discovering the world outside their playpen. Now the topic of today's analyzation we'll be covering is nothing new, I'm sure, or something someone has probably already talked about, but I'm going to throw in my two cents. So here we go. What is the mind-blowing plot hole we'll be discussing in this episode? Well, the other day I was watching Rugrats and discovered something strange. In the season 1, episode 8 of Rugrats called Real or Robots, we hear Stu utter a pretty confusing line considering what us fans find out later on in the movies and continuation of the show. You see, as Stu turns off a movie the babies Tommy and Chuckie were watching and tucks them into their crib for the night, Stu turns to Chuckie and says something in short like this, "Good night, Chuckie. Your mom and dad will be here to pick you up in the morning." Now there's the plot hole. As we find out later in the show and also in the movies, Rugrats in Paris, Chuckie's mom passed away when and or around the time he was little, like newborn age. And what I find odd is why the writers would have Stu say something like that unless they didn't know that Melinda, aka Chuckie's mom, would be killed off. But either way, that's not the only piece of this plot hole puzzle. We also see an inconsistency later in the movie Rugrats in Paris, where we see Chuckie's dad, Chaz, looking through old photos of him and Melinda and baby Chuckie. But in the photos, it seems there's a problem. In the movie, the photo is shown of a young white female with brown hair. And in the series, in another episode called Mother's Day, we see a young white female with red hair. Now, I know what you're going to say, and yes, I suppose it's possible Melinda was just maybe a fan of hair dyeing. But all in all, I thought this plot hole seemed a bit too obvious to me. But then again, the only reason I can see the writers not bringing more attention to the first point of what Stu said earlier is the possibility of the writers not being sure how this whole series would go, so they decided the fate of Melinda Finster later on after having filmed the Real or Robots episode. Anyway, that's enough rambling for now. I hope you enjoyed and maybe even got some insight or learned something you didn't know before. If so, be sure to like the video and leave a comment about any theories or plot holes you found interesting throughout the show. This is Sherlock Fan Number 1 signing off. Bye! It's the heart.